Thank you so much for that. In particular, that very generous introduction, Joan. It's truly humbling. I would like to begin by expressing my gratitude to the CPSO, to the Award Selection Committee, and to the Council today for this recognition. This award recognizes the concurrent hats doctors wear as clinicians, but also as leaders, academics, and advocates for our patients and our communities, and it celebrates this. It is critical to all of us, especially in this time of unprecedented challenge during the pandemic, to know of the support of the CPSO with respect to the many roles physicians assume in our society. I would like to express my gratitude to my nominators for this award, of course, and for all the work that goes into these kinds of nominations, and to the primary care community that I'm so privileged to be a part of and with whom I share this honor. Like many others, I have been fortunate to have had phenomenal mentors in medicine, from Dr. Charles Charnowski in residency at the University of Ottawa to Dr. Kathy Morris as our first dean at the Warley Regional Campus. I am especially mindful of the sacrifices of my staff and colleagues at the practice who support me in balancing myriad responsibilities. I believe that health equity and access to primary care is vital to the well-being of our communities. Understanding barriers to care, why certain populations are disproportionately affected, highlighted as an example as our Black and white non-white racialized communities during this pandemic, is key. When thinking about how to redesign systems, we need to ask ourselves two questions. First, who is the system not working for? And second, who is not at this table that should be? And question one is always the answer to question two. It requires bravery to lean back and create space for those who are not traditional power brokers in the system. This reaching in and meeting people where they are is central to family medicine. Another mentor, Dr. Judy Bell Brown, the program director of the Graduate Studies Program in Family Medicine at Western University, speaks often about the patient-centered clinical method. And just as we ask one-to-one our patients about their family backgrounds or influences and contexts, we need to think about these factors when planning population health also. All Ontarians should have access to team-based primary care, to a well-integrated system, and to culturally appropriate care. And in my work as part of the Ontario Health Team in my community, I see opportunity to truly transform our system. Another wonderful colleague of mine, Dr. Clover Hemmons, with whom I share the privilege of co-chairing OMA Women, is fond of saying the following phrase: "You cannot be what you do not see." And this sums up why we need to lean into intentional representation of patients, caregivers, and their families, of diverse populations, and of course, women physicians. Healthcare leadership needs to look like the communities we serve. And I cannot conclude without turning to my incredible patients. Serving you, my patients, is the honor of a lifetime. And finally, thanks to my children, my support system. While my parents and husband are delighted to hear every new role I take on, they're the cheerleaders. It is my brother, Paul, who is my life coach, who challenges me to protect my free time and have some fun. We all need a person like this in our lives, who takes care of us as we take care of others. And on that note, once again, I thank you, Joan, and the CPSO Council for this award that I share with my primary care colleagues. I am humbled and truly grateful for all the college does for us. Thank you.